Good evening, everyone. How are you tonight? Coaster T-Fox here with another video for you tonight. I have to talk a little quiet this evening because my mom's asleep and nobody knows that I'm a furry, so I'm going to make sure I keep this kind of under wraps for now, okay? Okay, just for now. But anyway, I'd like to show you the creation I have here. My very first balaclava. This is made, of course, with my handy-dandy sewing machine. I'd like to show you that right now. Take a look. Okay, got it on. All right. And this is how it looks on my face. Yes, we have this nice look here. And as you can see, the jaw moves really well. I used a slightly lighter thread so it's easily seeable. It allows me to stitch the piece together more easily because I'm a beginner at this and it's my first time sewing. These here are seam allowances that I left on here just in case for this piece right up here. So, and it's it fits perfectly, so I think I can clip these off now. This is a under chin adjustment strap. It keeps this from going over my mouth, because if it goes over my mouth, I can't speak clearly, and people definitely would want to hear me speak clearly, so. Anyway, so I'll actually take this off so you can get a better look at it, so you can make one yourself, if you would like. So here, allow me to get you a better look at how I made this. Okay, first of all, here is the strap for the face, for the chin. Just a simple straight stitch. I backstitched about 3 times. I think I said that right. Well, anyway, I forward stitched, backstitched once. These are 3 stitches, but I backstitched once. Forward, back, forward. And I did that all the way around in a continuous seam, so that way I wouldn't have to continue to cut thread and have a loose end, which would cause us to unravel if that was the case. And we definitely don't want that. So, anyway, we also have the understrap right here. Keeps it on my chin in the perfect location so it doesn't go up over my mouth, which would be a bad idea. We definitely wouldn't want that. So anyway, I'm going to turn it over to the side. I think I'll lay this down for you. Might come off a little better for you in the video. Okay, same with the side, all the way around, and just one stitch across, because I don't need to overly stitch this, because I want it to be flexible. And it's good. It's a strong stitch. It's a very strong stitch. I tested it. Very good. The back. Zigzag stitch. And this is just where I tacked it, where I marked it and tacked it just to get the line started. Same with this side. And then I just combined it together with a zigzag stitch. This zigzag stitch all the way around the balaclava. This is a very lightweight spandex material, breathable. It does get warm, but you're not going to roast in this thing. It does keep sweat away pretty nice. Pretty nice. And as you can see, I used a light color thread on one side and black on the other because that's the only thread that I had at the moment. But anyway, yeah, it came out pretty well. This is the side that will be connected to the foam on the fursuit, this side. Same with here. And, down here I just used a straight stitch because it doesn't need to be stretchy because this is just going around the neck of the person that's wearing it. And yep, there it is. That is my basic balaclava moving jaw fursuit piece that will be the base for Coaster, for his head. So there's that. And everybody, if you would like more information about fursuit building and such, I would recommend you check out Beetle Cat and Tisa Braces. Those are great starts for getting ideas for fursuit building. And So also I'd like to let everyone know that I will be having a Q&A video video coming up very soon, and I hope everyone can attend that. And feel free to ask me whatever questions you like, and I will answer those in a following video. So thanks for watching, everyone, and remember to stay calm and love furries. Bye for now.